streaming? Are we streaming? Are we streaming? I gotta go check. Oh, it's not live yet. Oh, there he is. Alright. You see things, and they are on. We are on, we are live. I'm chillaxing a little bit today. I'm gonna take a little bit of a day off. My cat's being very, very lovey today, so if she jumps up in the middle of the screen, I'm gonna say hello. You're gonna say hello to my kitty. My kitty is like, man, I want to get on camera with you too. I want to get on camera with you too. Can I get on camera with you too? Which is amazing because here's the funny thing. When I first, and someone will attest to this, there was a witness, okay? When I first put this thing on and I did like a video recording, basically, she got really it was like, oh, I can't stand this. No, why would you do that? Oh, she's getting in my lap. Say hello, kitty. Say hello, kitty. Hello, world. I'm going to be an interrupting person. I'm going to be interruptive of this entire process. Anyways. Enough about the cats. Now that I've completely ruined my whole shtick. By the way, if you're curious as to what my t-shirt says, I found this one online recently. I said, oh, why the heck not? I rarely splurge on myself, so it was too tempting. It was basically what's it say? Always be yourself. Unless you can be a kangaroo, then always be a kangaroo. Freaking awesome. I love the slogan. I don't know who came up with it, but I was like, oh, I has to buy. It wasn't a furry site. It was off of Amazon, so I'm not supporting the furry shirt makers. I'm a terrible person. Anyways, I'm sure you could find it if you were looking for it. But anyways, we're here for a game, aren't we? We're here to play a game and to introduce you to a game. So Sonic Mania recently looks very, very hype. A lot of Sonic fans get very, very hype. Little known about me, I was a Sonic fan back in the day. And as a furry writer, you might know I do furry writing things. I did Sonic fan fiction back in the day. Oh God. Oh God, why am I admitting this on camera? Actually, Men was very well received. I like the character Hi. Tails, so I guess
little
we should
known about me.
Play Tails.
I was
here.
A Sonic fan back in the day.
It'd help if I got off of my
looking at
furry
my screen
writing,
you might
and actually looking
furry
at
writing
the game
things.
I'm
I did
playing.
Sonic fan fiction back in the
there
day.
There we go.
Oh God!
So I don't see myself lagging.
Oh God! Why am I admitting
like
this
crazy,
on camera,
crazy, man? All right, so I could select Sonic
actually,
Tails.
Actually, Men was very well received.
In this game,
I like
you know, I was always a Tails fan.
So I guess little known about me. Play Tails.
I was
so,
a
Sonic fan.
I
help
with Tails today.
Of
I don't know.
Looking
at might go for Sonic, might go for Tails. I think I'll go for Tails. Just because it's in my comfort zone. So I could change resolutions. I'm not going to do that because I've seen what resolution changes do to the stream. And none of that, but I've made all this cool adjustments to my stream and really make it work. So let's just start up.
And
see if the sound's working. Nope. But the sound is like the best part, dude. You can't play Sonic games without sound. I don't even know what's going on. like the bone magnetic picking up. I don't see much in the sound. I was listening on the sound setting to try and get it working.
Well, actually, let me
see. Well, that was interesting. Hey, I think it's actually working now. Oh, I hate streaming. I'm not a fan. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry, Twitchies. I'm not a big fan of this. Well, then again, this is like, I'm not really working with a game that's used to, you know, that's... this is really developed for, so you can expect technical difficulties, right? I'm surprised if you get it working right. So we're gonna play the game. So you start off with story mode, you get classic mode. And you have to play through story mode first in order to unlock classic mode, but I'll just do classic mode. So as you can see, they start off with a very a level that seems to be inspired by, what's it called? The Sky Sanctuary Zone. From Sonic 3 and Knuckles. It's also inspired by another level design of theirs, which was, basically, they did another one before the sequel. I'm not too big a fan of before the sequel, but it's probably because I was playing on a computer that didn't play the last level correctly, so it made finishing the game absolutely impossible, which is interesting, because there's like a little flash lag or something. So basically there was a mechanic that was required to get through the last parts of the game, and I couldn't get through it, so I was kind of a little upset about that. But now that I have a new machine, I might be able to get through it, but... so, the thing is about the great fan games, there's a bunch of fan games with Sonic the Hedgehog. It's like, it's interesting the difference between, you know, Mario and Sonic fan projects, is that Sonic fan projects, they seem to be a lot more free, and, or a little bit more, like, there's a lot more of them, which is very interesting, because I don't know if it's because, you know, Sonic seems to, like, present this laissez-faire feel about it. I just don't know why. It's like there's just like a different psychology behind Sonic fans and Mario fans. I mean, Mario fans make some content, and I've seen, you know, there's some good, they make some good content as well, but it's usually the quantity of it is a little bit shorter. And the quality of it's a little bit, like, the quality of it's about the same, I think, like, on average. But, you know, the quantity of it is just completely different. And I don't know why that is. And it might be because, and this might be a little controversial to say, but Mario games seem to come out on a better tick and have better quality overall than Sonic games do. And, you know, the fact that everyone loved the Sonic character and they don't feel that the developers who are actually in charge of making the official projects you know, are so good at it that they have to feel like they have to fill the niche. And as you can see, the fans are pretty good at filling that niche when they can. I mean, obviously, they make, there's just for one good project, there's probably like, ooh, I get a bonus stage. Wow. Apparently, me talking while playing this makes me a better player at it than when I'm doing it by myself. Because I had 96 rings. I didn't even realize that because I can't see crap. Ah! Sonic 2 Special Stage Remix. Okay, so you want to avoid those things. Okay, so they were teaching me a mechanic there because I couldn't avoid those. So what they were doing is like, you don't want to hit the green things, but you want to hit the blue things because they'll accelerate you. And that was kind of a way to teach me the mechanic without giving me a text dump on the screen going, yeah, this is how this mechanic works. Because I haven't really played this in a long time, so I forgot about the mechanic, but I remembered it thanks to their little show don't tell kind of a thing, which is great, because I was able to get the first Chaos Emerald first try. So they have this, and this is what I love about this fan game in particular. There are mechanics of great game design, and you could tell that they've studied, like, online videos or whatever about how to design concepts in video games. And they show that talent of doing that. Because every level kind of has its own thing, and they kind of show it to you a little bit on what they expect you to do. The first two are obviously like just kind of normal levels. If you played a Sonic game, you would... Ah, no! Do I fly back up there? The music's great, too. Like, the music is freaking awesome. I like this particular level. There's highs and there's lows. Obviously in a great soundtrack like this. Which you could find online. I posted on the YouTubes. I might post a link down below for their soundtracks. But, as you can see, it's like it's, loop-de-loop. I didn't even see that loop-de-loop. It was a hidden loop-de-loop. Oh, the second loop-de-loop. Those are cool little moments. It definitely gives you that very old, classic-y Sonic feel. It's kind of why I wanted to play this one for you guys, because some people might not even know this game exists. I did an article on it for Flavor about 2 years ago, talking about it. And the funny thing about it is that I think Sonic Team has taken notes. And it's very interesting, and it's kind of the reason I wanted to choose to play a quote-unquote fan game, is because I think Sonic Team has finally taken notes, or at least the developers of Sonic were like, you know what, let's hand off some of these smaller projects to, like, these fan dudes. You know what I mean? And make actual official products for it, because, everyone knows the Sonic Mania is under the control of somebody who did, I can't remember my name, I think it was White? Christian White? I can't remember off the top of my head. See, I'm a Sonic fan, but I'm not, like, such a fan where it's like I know everything about their little fan developers and stuff like that. I don't know what's it called, Retro Sonic or whatever it's called, that website. I know it exists, I know what it is. I just don't know the people. It's like I'm not part of that community, per se. I was more in the fanfiction community back in the day than the game designer aspects. Of course, you know, I kept in the know enough to apparently learn about this game when it first came out. Probably through a YouTube video or something. Okay, whoa, whoa! Whoa! I found a bug! Holy shit! This is wow! Holy! Oh god! What have I done? Oh, the YouTubes! Oh no! The bugs! I wonder if they have a time out of 10 minutes. I don't know if I want to find out. How do I? No, this is horrible. And they need a kill me button. Okay, I'm gonna have to do something weird here. Take five, guys. Let's watch his idle animation, because it's like... yeah? It's like... That is the funniest thing ever. I never thought, like, when I recorded this, that was gonna happen. I didn't intend for that to happen. This is how speedrunning begins, folks. Unfortunately, this is not a useful glitch for that kind of a thing, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit pause and I'm gonna hit the reset button. Beep, beep, beep. So, pro tip, don't fly around that platform, unless you want something weird to happen, because something weird just happened, man. I gotta tell you, I did not expect that whatsoever. Lake Feppard is his name. He's a body of water. So now I'm gonna have to start that level over again, which I didn't expect to have to do, but we're gonna do it anyway. So let's go ahead and do that. Oh man, one of them days, huh? It's Sunday, man. Miracles happen. So we hit the load game. So that's a good way to introduce that to you. You hit load game and it loads it for you. So if you really wanted to be a jerk and you really wanted to game the system, if you realized that you weren't going to have like 50 rings by the time you hit the end of the stage, you could be smarmy and go, well, I'm going to reset the entire game and then try again and do that. So. But at least it gave me a chance to. It's like at least it gives me a chance to not mess this part up again. And what do I do? What do I do as soon as I say it? I put my big old foot in my mouth, and for real, that is not a good thing to do, to put that big old foot in your mouth, because it is a huge foot and not so huge a mouth. I get to do the double loops again. Double loops. I ever have that deja vu feeling? I just got hit. Luckily I had a shield on. Don't fly around you. The saddest part is I think that spinny platform near the end there is actually near the end of the level, so I basically had to redo this whole second act, but it was entertaining, and I kind of have to reset now, man, because I just lost all my rings. The bugs, man, the bugs. Oh, the bugs. But you know, for the fact that this is a fan-made game, like, they have that one bug there where, like, to me, I rarely run into bugs in this game, which is quite polished and nice, and it's like, it's pretty cool that it's so polished. The fact that I ran into that one bug, you know, that's the first time I've run into a bug. I've played this game probably 3 times through. And it's amazing to me let's be a little cautious there. Yep, I was right near the end of the act. I knew it. I remembered that. You gotta pitch this. Hold on a second. So, no special stage for me on that one. Because I suck. This one, it's like, this music's cool, but this act goes on a little long, and it's somewhat repetitive, but, the concept of this one's pretty interesting, and you're gonna see it pretty soon. Basically, while I'm in here, thunderstorms are gonna start up. So they got rid of the parallax background for a moment so that they could change the scenery in the background to make it more stormy, which is, pretty neat. So the concept they're introducing you there is that there's going to be invisible platforms, and you're only going to be able to see them under... I thought that was going to be. But basically, they're only going to appear during thunderclaps. And so you got to be careful about... It ends up causing weird things to happen like that. It's like, oh... So you jump around, find platforms, and then, of course, if you've played the level enough, apparently, like, when it comes to Sonic games, I've only played this game, like, 3 times through, but when it comes to Sonic games, I'm pretty good at memorizing where platforms are, for some freaking reason. Maybe I should do one of these things blindfolded, for the entertainment's sake. Maybe I'd have to do a mainstream one, like Sonic 3 or something. That's the thing too. Like, I know that the games done fast thing has become kind of a craze recently. Maybe if we can do like games done blindfolded or something, that'd be interesting. I mean, certainly my view is obscured with this thingy on my face, but I can still see quite fine. Though the dim lighting doesn't help. See, this is the kind of cool thing about this particular song, though, because it has that little, and that kind of, it kind of has that watery feel to it. I mean, there's definitely a lot more water in this particular act than the previous ones because of the rain. So it kind of gives it that feel, like, the music complements the environment, and... Here's the thing that Sonic games have been about. People don't realize that this is what Sonic games are about. People are like, it's about the speed, it's about the characters, it's about... No, it's about the environment. It's about the environment, and it's about the music that complements that environment. And that the adventure that you have going through the game makes you feel like you're on this adventure to these exotic locations. And if your game lacks that, it lacks a little bit of something. So, a lot of people praised, Sonic, the Generation Sonic, for its gameplay, and I said, yeah, it got back, it was good in gameplay. The problem that I had with the game was that the environments were a bit samey. Like, about 4/7 of the stages were, like, cities and urban areas, like Crisis City and, Sophia and like City Escape, and like there was like so many city based levels that it just kind of made it urbane to me. Like the whole entire game was a little bit urbane. Whereas like Sonic, 3, it's like every level, you know what level you're in when you're looking at a screenshot. Like you know exactly where that is. Like, 'cause I've been there, I know where that is because it looks, each level is its own aesthetic, and you know exactly where it is, just by looking at a screenshot. Whereas, maybe if you took a Sonic Generations screenshot, other than some of those first few levels, you might be hard-pressed to go, well, I know where that is. There's other things about Sonic and what it used to be versus what it is now. And things that I'm going to bring up during the whole thing, but I'll bring it up in more, when it's context savvy. As I said, this act is a pretty good track. Now, as you notice, they don't have a swimming animation for Tails, which is unfortunate, but they obviously focused on Sonic a little bit more than Tails, which is fine. No super acts for me. I'm not doing too good. They use the Sonic CD transition. Now, this is probably the most creative boss in the entire game, I would say. It is the most creative and the best boss in the entire game, I think. That's just my opinion, but... So this comes in two stages. The first stage here is some Robot Tails dude, and Robotnik, or who calls him Robotnik? Eggman! So the whole point of this one is not to damage the robot tails, which it's actually to. But hitting him is not bad. It's just that he's not the thing you're trying to hurt. You're trying to hurt Eggman here. And what the Tails robot actually kind of acts like a linebacker, if I use a sports analogy. He's the one, he's trying to protect Eggman. Forgive me, I'm gonna up. Yeah, and so you want to bump him out of the way, otherwise he can act as a shield. Now it's more when you have to fight him directly. As soon as he stops, he's gonna throw a ball of lightning and stuff, so you gotta be careful. Oh no, hold on, don't fight him yet. Hold on. I'm playing it safe, guys. I don't wanna. Nope, okay. That follows you anywhere. I'm getting hit a lot. Hey, I beat myself up. Take that, robot me. There's only one Tails. Who has two Tails? That's all you get. So you can opt out of playing the cutscenes if you want to play other cutscenes, but they're pretty good and well done, so I don't... Yeah, you took all the credit there. Yeah. Something useful. Now this level is extremely creative. This one coming up. I freaking love it. Sonic, he gets a boost from these sugar mounds. I don't think Tails gets a boost as much. But he can fly, so what's it matter? So these are little sand waterfalls that you can kind of go down and jump off of them. Now Sonic has like the little nice like skidding animation that goes down though, so obviously Sonic's character model and like the way that he does things is a little more polished than Tails is. Oops. Yeah, those little sugar mounds, when you hit him with Sonic, he starts going in like a... He goes... Ah! It's really hard to keep on the upper parts of the level in this particular level because of these little springy things that will bounce you around. But Tails is a cheater. He's a filthy, filthy cheater, so he can go... He can go like, haha, yeah, I'm back. This is something I didn't notice until just now, but like it's got the rolling hills, but it's also kind of got this blocky feel to it. So, and that's kind of like how Sugar is, you know? When you zoom in on Sugar, it kind of has this like very square, cubish kind of formation to it. So while it has like a lot of rolling hills and stuff like that, it also has very, Eight Lane for Water. Yeah, his animation there needs a little work. It's one of the, like, the little few things they could have done with Tails a little bit better. Sonic's is fine, obviously. He actually looks like he's swallowing a thing. I'm gonna drown waiting for this bubble. Oh, there we go. Well, yeah, I've always found it interesting that there's so much water in this level. course. Magic, mysterious. There we go. Like one of these springs has got to work. Ah, there we go. No bonus stage here either. Like, I'm not doing too well. Whoa, this is a glitch. It's like, yeah, your tally's done. Reader Reaper said he liked this one better. I don't think so. I think I like the third axe better. He said he liked the, like, that going. You'll hear it when it comes up. It is kind of a cool effect, but I like the third ones better. Actually, I'd say the third act song for this particular level is probably the best one in the soundtrack. Like, it's hard. It is like one of the best ones in the soundtrack. And I think it is the first. Like, to me, it is the top one. As we go through the game, we'll go like over my other picks. We're coming up on the effect that he likes. Yeah. It's quite long songs for, man, I am taking a lot of damage. There it is. This is kind of cool how it kind of has you wavering in and out of the bad guys. But yeah, that was the effect he was talking about. It's like, it's kind of cool. It's kind of cool. It's even cooler, though, if you're in the water, because that actually gives it the environmental feel. But because I wasn't in the water, it just didn't really have that feel to it. So it really is context of how well that effect works. Don't shoot me with fire. It's kind of interesting to me how Tails is, like, immune to sugar. Like, is he, like, all hyped up already or something? Like, because Sonic will end up happening when if he like, hits him out like that, or if he gets hit by that, bad guy's, baddie's, like, little thing, he'll end up, like, his eyes will dilate, and he'll be, like, super running fast and stuff. He'll be, like, crazy fast running and doing all that stuff. It's kind of funny to watch. But Tails is like, seems to be out, immune to that kind of thing, and that sucks, because that, we got quite a bit of rings on that person. And I think we're almost done with the level. Oh well, I got a bunch of rings I can take here. Yeah. Be careful, please. Alright, I think this is the final kind of place, so I gotta be quite cautious here. Being quiet because I don't want to lose my rings, man. Yeah, I did it. You know, it's like, and he's like, why do you have the things memorized already? And it's the three thing, like, that there is a structure to the game design, and it's such where you can actually kind of pick it up and understand kind of how the developer thinks. I don't know what this is for. I'm not that big of a Sonic fan, must be. Baby, it's all about momentum. No! Wow, that's a solid stop. Gotta be careful, I'm flying. Oh wow, I'm doing too hot. No! Oh my god, I lost it. Wow. Here's a pro tip, I guess. Don't fly, because that solid stopped me. Like, as soon as I hit that green thing when in flying form, I was like, boom! Like hitting a brick wall. This one is my favorite track of the game. And it's also, I don't know if they did this on purpose, but the design of this level is also extremely creative and creepy, almost. Because here's the thing about Sonic games. It used to be like there was an environmentalist message behind it. Because you were fighting against the man. And he, you know, and he had this like, there's this one level in Sonic 2 where it's like, you're in this ocean, you know, this oil ocean. You see the damage that this Robotnik Eggman character has been doing to the environment. I jokingly called it the BP zone back in 2010. Because, you know, certain oil incidences in the Gulf Coast. But, you know, at the same time, like, this, in its own sneaky way, you notice how there's, like, this water thing. And this is kind of the mechanic of the level. Where every once in a while, and then boom, the water comes out. So, when I was reading something about fracking, they use tar sands or something like that, and then they blast, like, high-pressure water through it. Now, if you notice in this level, now all of a sudden you're like, oh! See, you notice that all this sugar has been kind of, like, in a kind of sandish formation, where they're in piles and they're kind of dune-ish. So, this, you know, we have these sugar sands, and you have this high-pressure water system blasting through this particular zone every once in a while. So, in a way, this level is very much a sort of very tongue-in-cheek hydrofracking thing. I don't know if the designer had this in mind when they created the level, but if it was, then holy cow, was it not only, like, super clever, but just completely blows, like, any level design that I've known from recent Sonic games out of the water. Even puts the older ones to shame, because it's like, it's so subtle, like, it's subtle, because not anyone playing this who doesn't know what hydrofracking is, or, you know, how it's performed, would kind of think that that's what's going on here, what it's, you know, what this is, what's going on with this. Even like, I did it post, like, playing this game. I was like, because I was reading about hydrofracking and stuff like that, and what it pertains, and I was like, wait a minute. Then I got back to this level, and I'm like, oh, you cheeky, cheeky, cheeky man. That's freaking clever. Because I'm like, sands and high-pressure water, and then the instant I heard those two words, that phrase is kind of put together, I was like, I see how it is. I see how it is. And they're very tight tunnels, too. Like, that's kind of the whole thing about it, like, and, you know, when you're doing hydrofracking, you know, you're putting in high-pressure situations, so you have this kind of very narrow, claustrophobic kind of feel to it. Yeah, they'll glitch out sometimes too. This level is very, like, boss or enemy heavy, and it's really hard to get. So that was level 3, Shoerig. That was fun. I liked that level. For the reasons I just said, like, it put a whole new level. Like, I liked the level before, but then it was like, wow. That's crazy. See, that's what he looks like when he gets super high. Oh, we got pressured out of there. So, there's no boss for this level, which is the weirdest thing. It is the weirdest thing. I don't understand why there's no boss for this level, or why it works like that, but it's kind of strange. But anyways, we're going to move on to the next one, the third act of the first 3 acts. This is another cool thing about this game, is that it has 3 acts per level, but it also has 3 sets of 3 levels that sort of feel like their own kind of separate stories and games, because, like, there's very much a climax at the end of each third act that seems more epic than most other things. So it kind of has this 3-act-within-3-act structure going for it. This will probably be the last level I play for this particular streaming session. Maybe. Depends on how I feel and what time it is, I suppose. So the level designer actually did talk a little bit about this level in his ending credits, and saying it's kind of inspired by sort of the place around where he lives, and there was something else that inspired it as well. I think it was like the some Sonic Heroes level, the electric, that second level, which I can kind of see the aesthetics in here. Now, the interesting thing is that what he notes is that a lot of these levels were inspired by Sonic Heroes levels, and I go, well, I guess Sonic Heroes did do something good in the world, I suppose. Ouch. Shots fired. Sorry. So it's like, if you like Sonic Heroes, but you want a 2D version that's actually pretty good, then yes, this is a good game to play. Here's the thing, it's like, there's good Sonic games, there's bad Sonic games, there's mediocre Sonic games. I think that, you know, Heroes was mediocre. It wasn't, like, horrible. I did play a lot of it. I actually played it to completion, which, back when I had enough time to do something like that. If I played it today, I probably wouldn't play it to completion, because I'd be, you know, I've got too much crap to do these days, because I'm a fully functioning adult and I decide what that means. So I'm at 40 rings, so hopefully I can get 10 more and not lose them. Yay, I got 10 more, so I gotta not lose them. And I think I'm near the end, if I don't be careful. As soon as I made that jump, I'm like, I'm gonna land right back on that thing, aren't I? No, yep, that's what I'm gonna do. I hate your stupid little top hat face. I hate you. And your cute little bug shape with the top hat. So, I guess they were making up for a lack of a boss in the last level by putting a mini boss in there. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows? What I do know is that because of that stupid bug, I lost my ability to do a special stage that level. I am doing horrible. So this is an interesting level, and it's actually also interesting in that, like, it's the first time since, like, Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I like that background thing that you're doing here. But be cautious. Everything else back there is moving slow, but this one's moving fast. So this is kind of cool. Now, here's the thing. If I were Sonic the Hedgehog, I would have like a different... Like, you notice I have this weird little get-up here. Sonic would actually have the way of, like, busting through these things. I can't. So basically, like, back in Sonic and Knuckles, when you had, like, different levels for both characters, this one's specifically designed for Tails. So if I came back here and played as Sonic, I would have a completely different level. So it kind of does the, for this level only, for this particular act. Now I don't know if I can make it back through this whole thing. This is something I've been trying to, you know, make it through, is trying to figure out if I can, but basically, you know, you could probably make it through the act with this costume. If I get hit, I lose. So I want to try to avoid that. There's also interesting things you can do by jumping and doing it at the same time, which I'm about to show. These guys gotta be patient with, because... So if I jump real quick, see those things down there? I can't get to them, right? So if I jump and do this real quick, like, if I hit the X button while I'm jumping, I can do this weird little split thingy which does damage. But only in the angles of which I'm jumping. So if I jump at an angle, then it will go with the angle. So that's how you get those buttons. Gotta be careful with these circle dudes.
Ah, yeah!
Nope, I want that one. Give that for me. Thank you. I think there's some time left in the level to regain my rings. Just gotta be careful. As I said, this part's designed for Tails, so it's like, well, you can bounce on those dudes or you can fly. Oh, no! No! Or maybe I'm being an idiot. I think I'm being an idiot, guys. Somewhat idiot. Ah! This level is a tough one. Like, I there's enemy placement, and there's... Like, those guys are a pain. The circle guys, because they die, but sometimes they're, like, their little laser thing stays behind for a little bit, and then shoots their thing after they die, and it can be pretty annoying. So I think I gotta go up there and grab a new thingy. Chaos Emerald, and how many levels do I have left? So there's three acts, so there's three times three is nine, right? Three times three is nine, but there's three of those, so nine times three is 27, so there's 27 acts total. They're like, haha. See, this song's pretty cool. The level, it's okay. It kind of gets a little repetitive. So basically the whole gimmick of this one is that you get blown up by these fans, and you get got to avoid the spikes, and you get it. You see it, you understand it. That's the whole premise. I don't have to explain it to you in a tutorial. It shows you exactly what I have to do, and I do it. Smaller like this actually kind of helps. Oh, I'm at 40. I'm probably near the end. Oh, there's 50. Oh, boy. That was the moment for me to screw up. Let me screw up for you. I don't know how close I am to the end. I think I might be close to the end, but I'm not sure. So what am I at? Like one out of every three? Because there's 7 Chaos Emeralds, right? So 7 out of 20 levels I need to do that for? 7 out of 27? But unfortunately, because we have not. Oh, okay. It repeats the... Okay, I get it. So I don't even move on to the next one until I get this one right. Oh my god. So at least I should kind of have an idea of how this one works. Okay. It's hard to predict. Oh my god, really? There we go. We got the second one. And we're 1/3 through the game. So, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3. Division! Doing it in my brains! 2 divided by 7 is 2/7. Yes, it's 2/7. Very good. So it's 2/7 less than 1/3. Is the question. So 2 out of 6, I think, would be 1/3. So 2 out of 6 would be a third, so I am actually a little behind. But not too bad. Of course, the levels get worse and worse. I mean, it's how they're designed, right? To get harder and harder, so probably not in good shape for getting all 7 Chaos Emeralds in one. Oh my gosh, so this is a little cheesy, I'm sorry.
Look at me jumping on all these things, man.
That was a little showy, wasn't it, Sonic? Shut up! I'm doing it for the camera, man! Little epic songs here. Now this one, I don't think I can get a special rating, but... So this one's definitely kind of got that whole Winged Fortress feel to it. But they kind of use, like, battery blimp sort of... It's kind of battery blimp aesthetic, but it's definitely got the Winged Fortress feel to it. Those guys are mostly harmless. They drop their load a little too early.
That's what he said.
Okay, I can't monetize this on YouTube anymore. I just made a innuendo joke. Oh no. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna actually have to contribute to society in order to make my money. Why, world? Why? You're so cruel! Not saying that YouTubers don't provide meaningful tools to society. But the world needs us coal miners. I'm not a coal miner. I'm not as good as a coal miner. I'm a little more frivolous than that. Anyways, so this guy here. Hi, you look familiar. This guy is, like, extremely, like, I don't know, it's kind of epic-ish, but it's like, oh man, it's like, it's the Metal Sonic dude, it's freaking epic and awesome, and it's like, but it's like, either it's a prototype, or it's like, really, because it does the same pattern over and over, and that's one of my critiques about this game, is that the bosses are a bit samey. Jump over that thing, jump over that thing, hit him. Jump over that thing, jump over that thing, hit him. Jump over this thing, jump over that thing, hit him. And it kind of, you can kind of beat most bosses with them. Now, to be fair, most Sonic games are kind of like that. If you go back and think about it really hard, it's like... There's never really been like a super epic boss fight kind of thing that you can think of. There might be a few, but they're like... They're not the pattern. The pattern is mostly, you know, bosses with patterns and... things like that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna check it real quick. So it looks like I'm the only one here. So this is gonna go up in the YouTubes, I suppose. And the Death Egg heads to... So this is supposed to take... So the whole story thing behind this is supposed to take place between Sonic 2 and Sonic 3. So, that's him crash landing the thing onto the flying island of the thing, and, you know, going about doing that. Oh, uh-oh, what's going on? Uh-oh. Tails, you're not good at flying. Alright, so that's gonna do it for this one. I may come back to this one later on. But that's basically, there's basically 3 acts to the game, as I said, and that was kind of the first act. You go to, you play through that part, and then kind of get to this part, and then that's, this part's kind of its own act, 3-act structure. Because there's like a big story point in each, at the end of each act, I noticed. And that one was like, oh, they're looking at the island, and you're kind of understanding how, you know, this falls into the story arc and whatnot. But thank you very much for watching, anyone who did watch, but no one watched me live. I have to be better at announcing when I'll do these things. I might have to schedule something. I have to schedules things so that people will be more apt to understand when I will do them. Know that I will probably never be able to chat with this freaking thing on my face because reading text is hard to do. So having big, bright, colorful things is really helpful because of my old man vision. But at least I'll be used to my old man vision by the time I become old aged. That's a benefit. But anyways, thank you very much for watching. I'm going to get the hop out of here. Click that like, comment, subscribe button in the faces. I can't do that. I'm terrible at that. I'm always terrible at that. I need an end card. I'm going to get myself an end card. But thank you very much for watching anyway. And have a good day, y'all. Mm-hmm.